But let's say your New Year's resolution is more of an internal thing, a struggle that you might have. Maybe you're one of those many people who their New Year's resolution has to do with quitting smoking or drinking. Well, joining me on the program is someone who that struggle with quitting smoking is no stranger to him. He's a former smoker. He's also a restaurateur who's worked alongside people like Mario Batali. He's the owner of 23 restaurants worldwide, the author of several books, several on Italian wine, and his own memoir, Restaurant Man. And you might know him most famously for being a judge on the hit TV show on Fox called Masterchef, Joe Bastianich. Hi, Joe. How are you today?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm great, and thanks for coming on the program. So with the desire to quit smoking being one of the top New Year's resolutions over the last couple of years, how has this impacted you?
Well, I mean, in the restaurant and hospitality industry that I'm in, we have the highest population of smokers, second highest population of smokers of any industry. So for me to be able to partner with Blueprint to Quit, to spread the message of how to quit smoking successfully once and for all, it was a unique opportunity not only to share my personal story, but to bring to my industry a way to get people to quit that really works.
Now, that's surprising that working in the industry you work in, that will be one of the second most areas for people who smoke. Why do you think that is? I know on a show like MasterChef, it can be very stressful, but is it just as stressful in the kitchen for an everyday restaurant?
I think that the kind of people that are drawn to the restaurant industry are hardworking, compulsive, creative people, and maybe they are the kind of people who would be drawn to having a crutch like smoking, or they come in and meet other smokers within the industry. So listen, we're working while everyone else is partying and having a good time. We're working long hours. It's a very difficult job, and I think that the kind of people who come to it, you know, unfortunately succumb to cigarette smoking. But it's not an excuse, because not only will it shorten your life, but it also makes you inherently worse at what you're doing in the business. Whether you're a chef, a server, or a cook, you need to be able to smell and taste. Olfactory and taste are the two most important things. And by stopping smoking, you increase your ability to taste and smell food, and that is really important in our industry.
Now, when you first started, was this something where you first got into the food industry and you saw some of your coworkers doing this, and it seemed like a great stress release, and that's how you started?
No, I started, unfortunately, very young, you know, with friends in a social situation. It was a different time. I didn't realize how addictive and how deadly the habit was. So I came to the restaurant industry already as a smoker. I grew up in restaurants. But at a certain point, I realized that I had to make a change.
So what was that turning point for that change for you?
The turning point for me was really a couple of different things. I knew I had to start looking out for my long-term health. My first child was born, and I realized I wanted to become more of a leader in my industry, so I had to set an example. I had to become a better taster, a better wine taster, a better food taster, so I knew that quitting smoking would offer me that. So those three things really compelled me to quit smoking.
Now, that's interesting that you keep bringing up the fact that it does inhibit your ability for tasting and smelling. So I never thought about that when it comes to smoking, that you are losing a little bit of that sense of taste and smell.
Absolutely. And it's almost ironic that we have such a high population of smokers in an industry where taste and smell is so important. And, you know, for me, I did it in a way that I declared my intention, looked for the support of my family and friends, increased the amount of sports and athletics I was doing in my life, changed my diet, and avoided all the trigger points for smoking. That was a long time ago. I mean, today I'm happy to partner with Blueprint to Quit as a complete program to deal with all the aspects and difficulties and challenges in quitting smoking, both physical and behavioral. And if you want to check it out, go to walmart.com/blueprint to quit, and it's everything you need in one site to quit smoking once and for all.
Now, do you notice that those stresses of our everyday life, whether it's someone who works in the food industry or someone who has another stressful job, that's the main reason why people tend to take up something like smoking? Or is it also a lot to do with that social aspect as well?
I think it's a combination of everything is alluring, that's alluring about smoking. The problem is that it's highly addictive and deadly. And once you're addicted to nicotine, it's a very, very difficult habit to break, because it's not only the physical addiction, but also the behavioral aspects of the habit that are very difficult to break. And Blueprint to Quit really provides you with the tools to deal with both physical and behavioral issues involved in quitting smoking.
And you've mentioned a lot about the harms of smoking and how it is something that a lot of people can end up dying from. Did you find that when you were smoking, a lot of times people would say that and you would just kind of pass it off before you finally hit that one moment where you realize, okay, I need to change?
Yeah, I mean, I always knew it was bad. I always figured I was young. You know, I had time. But, you know, time sneaks up on you. There's no disputing the fact that it's dangerous and deadly. So it's just that it's not a matter of if you're going to quit. It's just a matter of when, if you want to live.
So what were some things specifically that helped you when it came to those cravings, when you were trying to quit, when it came to maybe that one day where you're like, oh, I really could use a cigarette, but you went for something else instead?
For me, I mean, I made a commitment to being on the Nicoderm CQ patch for almost 100 days. So I knew I had so much invested in quitting in the 10th, 20th, 30th day that I couldn't go back. I relied on the support and the support of dealing with the physical addiction through the patch. And the behavioral aspects, you know, I kind of cut my own road. I made my own way. I stayed away from trigger points. I didn't go to that bar. I didn't go to that park. I didn't have that cup of coffee. I made a real comprehensive life change in order to be able to quit smoking for once and for all.
So it really is about isolating yourself from all of those elements that you once associated with smoking until you were comfortable enough with the fact that it wasn't going to tempt you to be able to walk into, say, your favorite local bar.
Exactly. And it's always tempting. And it's also about, you know, just changing the whole way you live your life. Food, exercise, behavior patterns, everything.
Now, what about when it came to your friends and your family? How did they end up helping you? If you felt the need for a cigarette, would they be there right by your side saying, no, don't do this, let's go do this instead?
Well, you know, of course, they were very, I mean, I just had my first child. No one in my family was a smoker. I was the only one. They were very supportive. So, I mean, that's the kind of true support and team you need to get through this very difficult time.
Okay. And you have had a very successful career. You're working on MasterChef, which I feel like is taking off. Any other projects that you have in the works?
Oh, a lot of different things. We're opening up restaurants all over the world, and we're doing the fourth season of MasterChef, which will be on the air in the summer here in the United States. We do MasterChef in Italy. So a lot of good stuff happening. So, yeah, it's been good.
Well, thank you for coming on the program, Joe. It's been a real pleasure talking with you. Best of luck with everything in the future, and hopefully working with everything you're working with to help people quit smoking will help those people to stick to their New Year's resolutions.
Thanks so very much for having me.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Bye.
That was Joe Bastianich. You might recognize him as a judge on the hit TV show on Fox called MasterChef. He's also the owner of 23 restaurants worldwide. And in his career, he's worked alongside people like Mario Batali. He's the author of several books, some of which being on Italian wine. He has his own memoir out called Restaurant Man.